Compared to the vastness of outer space, we're no more than a dot on a canvas. A grain of sand in a stretch of desert, or a single snowflake on a snow-capped mountain. But if you look closer, you allow yourself to see, you'll find the miracles in lives lived.
In 2015, liver was failing during an emergency organ transplant.
5 years ago, Jillian Best was just another name on the organ transplant list. Now, looking to ultimately give back to the community that saved her life, she will attempt a 52-kilometer solo swim across Lake Ontario. Training continuously with fellow transplant athletes to increase her stamina and build tolerance to the cold water temperatures a Canadian winter provides, all to be able to endure what the deep lake has to offer. For more than 19 hours, she will battle the frigid waters, fatigue, and everlasting currents to raise funds and awareness for her nonprofit foundation, Move for Life.
The Buddha Palace.
Great.
So can you tell me what's going on?
Yeah, I'm doing an interview with Kenny Swood on 1290 AM News Talk Radio. I don't know who's listening at 6:50 in the morning, but...
It's something.
Something.
Lake Ontario. This is a 52-kilometer, at best, swim across Lake Ontario. Good morning, Jillian. Thank you so much for doing that. We appreciate it.
Thank you so much for having me. This is exciting.
Yeah, well, I mean, this is exciting for us, too, because last time we spoke, you were kind of just in the, you know, the beginning phases of this, in the planning stages, and, you know, kind of ramping up your training for, and I can't even imagine what a training for a 52 kilometers looks like. Where does your training stand now? Are you kind of plateaued?
Yeah. So the last time we spoke, I wasn't in the thick of it yet, and I've been through the thick of it, and I'm on the other side now where...
You just hang up on me like that. See ya.
Oh, these are the ice chunks. Wow, that's good enough. How often do you do the ice bath, or is this more like...
I was doing lots of ice dips, like, in the winter. Not as much like in the spring because I was swimming in cold water all the time, so I was getting my fill. But I did want to, a week ago, doing one today because I think it'll just help my, any inflammation. Kind of, I think it helps the mind too, like just getting in when it feels shitty and uncomfortable is usually a good thing.
Just help you like mentally overcome doing something that like your body doesn't really want you to do.
Exactly. Yeah, just to kind of prove to myself that I'm still a badass and I can I can handle some pain. Oh yeah, it's hurting.
I'm sure it's not warm.
It's not warm.
How long are you gonna do?
I should probably do 5 minutes.
5 minutes. Couple dragon's breaths.
Visualizations, limit distractions, just do everything that makes me feel good so that I'm mentally prepared and feeling good for the swim.
Yeah,
cookies,
coffee. We're
double stuff, family size. Oh, yeah.
Family size.
We did. We got the family size or double stuff.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh my god, it really is family size.
Yeah.
Because yeah.
Well, I also figured you guys can have some more.
Hi, I'm Lynn.
I'm a dietitian. I work at the hospital in London where Jill had her transplant, and I've known Jill since her transplant. And I'm going to be feeding Jill every 40 minutes while we're on the boat and while Jill's swimming. So she's going to come over to the boat, and we're going to pass smoothies. We're going to pass, we have baby squeeze, like oatmeal and things like that for her to drink, water, Gatorade. So she's going to feed every 40 minutes while she's swimming. And we've gone through to make sure she's getting enough fluid, enough salt, enough carbs to keep her energy high and her spirits high. And that's the plan.
Is there any like specifics that you're trying to stick to in terms of like what type of food, or is it just more whatever she's comfortable with type?
Yeah, we are doing mostly complex carbs for her so her energy's topped up and it's easy to digest. We don't want her to have gut grief out there. And so everything that we're going to be doing, Jill's tested already. The oat milk, the baby foods. So we're going to try our best not to do anything too new and too radical. We have targets for her fluid intake. 200 mils an hour is kind of our minimum. And so we're going to kind of watch, make sure she's staying well hydrated, that she's getting enough sodium so she doesn't get hyponatremia. And so we've gone through and we have a sport dietitian in New Zealand named Karen Zen, and she helped us and combed through it with us to make sure it looked okay, that that she's not taking too much or too little. So hopefully it'll work.
Yeah, that's my gut. I've worn all of them for long swims, so like any of them would work.
They're all good.
They're all good. This one, I think this is it. Yeah.
Just came back from a two-week trip with his wife in Europe, and he called just at 3:30 when I was going to call you. And,
oh, it's okay. I'm here now.
How are you feeling right now?
I'm actually feeling really excited. I'm having a hard time relaxing. But I'm sure once, you know, my company leaves, I will feel more relaxed.
Enjoy it, you know, and yeah.
Thank you so much.
We'll talk after it's all over.
Yeah, I would love that. And it means so much that you called me and, you know, that I got to talk to you before my swim.
Well, you know what? I have goosebumps right now just talking to you. So just so you know, I really do care and connect with the swimmers, and you become my people. So,
that's so cool.
Once you get your feet in that lake, you belong to me.
That's great.
So have a wonderful trip.
Thanks, Marilyn.
I'll talk to you tomorrow.
Okay.
Take care.
Okay.
Okay, take care.
Bye.
That's awesome.
T-minus 4 hours till go time.
Lake Louvre, and then just a quick 20-hour swim. We're good to go.
Just a quick dip. Go for a little tour around the lake.
Thank you. she's requested that one of us jump in the water and support her. So I'm so excited to get in the water and do what I can to help her accomplish this. Hopefully it lifts her spirits a little bit to have someone go in there with her, stroke for stroke. So I think I'll swim for about 40 minutes. She's been swimming about 2 kilometers in that amount of time, or 3 kilometers an hour. So I'll get in and swim that long and then see what else she needs.
It honestly means the world. Like, I am in awe that she's been swimming this long and she seems in good spirits. So I can't wait to get in the water and help her out.
Yes.
So we just got the pacer in the water. The pacer are there so they can show her what pace to keep and to lift her spirit. We have 4 pacers that are going to switch up during the day. You posted how it goes, but should be smooth sailing from now on. We're about 22 kilometers in, and Jill is going at a 60 stroke per minute pace since we've been off, and she's still at that pace, so everything's going really well.
Big smile on that face.
Yeah.
We're so often we'd look at each other, make funny faces. Yeah, she wanted the hug, but not worth the disqualification.
Not yet. Next up, Captain Steve.
All right.
Ready to
go?
You ready to go? You gonna do 2? For the team here.
So we are lead boat, solo. Solo swim, solo boat. We're heading due that way.
Yeah!
See ya. Oh, easy game.
Easy.
Atta girl.
I'm like so cold.
That's alright.
Okay.
Feeling good?
Amazing. Yeah. I can do
that was a double shift, I think.
Maybe not all day, but you did that a long time with her. It's like honestly pure bliss. Like you just like she's like a metronome. And yeah. I just like match her arms and it's like all day. Like you just go.
You get into that sync,
exactly,
you get into that rhythm, that flow.
Exactly. A couple of smiles, a couple of tongues out.
Smoothie or banana and water?
I'll do some smoothie.
Yeah.
And then some water.
In your element out there.
You have about 15K left.
15?
Yeah.
Okay.
Oh, that's nothing.
Nothing.
You're on great.
Nothing. Less
you're
than
gonna
a
blink.
Trial. Your energy's perfect. You're getting all the nutrients. It's
good.
Any soreness?
I'm not under eating.
No way. No way.
Trying
perfect.
To.
Okay.
Awesome.
Are you sore anywhere?
My throat's sore.
That's just from being awesome.
Yeah.
And my ankle.
Okay.
Hit him with it.
On the next one, we'll put some little nutrients in there. We'll give you a time or two.
Okay.
I'll take you right through.
Okay.
Battle girl, man.
Oh, sorry.
No, you're good. You're good.
Mallon sent me a text telling her that the Mallon Bell Park is waiting for her.
They're waiting for you.
Marilyn Bell sent a text to John saying that Marilyn's Bell Park is waiting for you.
Just around the corner, Jill, not too much further.
Oh. Yeah.
She said she's very proud of your efforts.
Yeah.
That's amazing.
She loves watching these things.
I talked to her on the phone.
Oh, that's so cool.
She told me she stays up at night.
Just a casual combo. 45K in. No big deal.
Okay. Next time.
The next one is for lunch. We'll give you guys.
Okay.
You got it. You got it, Jill. Find your rhythm again.
I'm okay, actually.
You want an Oreo?
41 in?
No.
Yeah, 49.
I'm good.
Okay.
Oh, no, you're right.
You good for water?
My math is wrong.
Okay, let's go.
She says you're like Nemo, and she is sending all her positive energy out to you.
Yes.
That's so nice.
She's been watching. All right, let's go. We got a boat.
Crush it, Joe.
See you later, guys.
See you later.
Thank you.
Thanks. Yeah, Marilyn Corsequa, who's watching the tracker, is monitoring the kilometers per hour and seeing that the they're getting slower in the last 3 hours. So we're just gonna check with Jillian and not get into all that, but just to encourage her to keep going and on the positive stuff.
There was a time where I knew we were so close. I could see the skyline so much more clearly now, but it didn't seem to be getting any closer. I'd ask how much left, and at each 40-minute segment when I'd pop up to get a drink, it seemed like I was barely moving, and my team just encouraged me to keep swimming.
This is grind time, Jill. You practice for this. This is where the training comes in, right here.
The looks of intent by my team made me feel like they were willing me on through their eyes, like, keep going.
Go, Jill! Yeah! Yeah!
I knew I wasn't moving very fast. I learned afterwards that there were talks about heading to a shorter exit in case I couldn't make it through this current that was pushing me backwards.
Yeah, glow sticks are still rocking.
But my team believed in me and we persisted through.
Bring her home, Gray, bring her home.
Good work, Steve.
You there?
Thanks, man.
Let's go. Let's go, Jill, you got this, girl. You're killing it.
Yes.
Woo! Woo! You got this, Jill.
Let's go, Jill.
No problem.
Home.
Well, the cold patches are really cold, like, and they're bigger. They envelope you, and it's almost a shock. I'm guessing it goes down like 12 or 13 or something like that.
Amy was talking about.
Yeah.
Last little bit. How was it?
Warm beverages.
It was great. She's doing great. She's gonna do it. She's right there. We've already cleared the island, so like that's. Like, it felt like we had some waves pushing us in.
That's good, that's good.
She has picked up speed, yeah. Picked up speed, yay!
We're in the last little 4K?
She's got now 3.82. So, and that tells you how much faster she's going now than she was 15 minutes ago.
Got through that curve?
Yeah, she did. It's gone. Totally gone.
This experience reflected so well the journey to having my liver transplant. I was gathering all the strength that I had left to make it to the finish. My friends on the boat were there, cheering and rooting me on, as that was the only thing they could do. Physically, I was on my own. I had to use whatever was inside me to keep pushing forward. What may have seemed like hours, watching me struggle and possibly even doubting for some time that I wouldn't make it through the rough patch. What remained was my belief in myself and the determination to get to the other side. And this was like my transplant journey. My family was all there to support me. But watching my energy fade away, and there was nothing they could do aside from being within arm's reach for emotional support. All I knew at the time was to just hang on and believe I'd be okay. I was oblivious to my condition. I just wanted to go through with what I said I was going to do. Survive and make it to the other side. There's a moment that I, of course, the moment where we were all swimming together. Like when John jumped in the water with me, like I knew that that wasn't something he had done before. He had never really gotten in on a swim as a swim master with anyone. And it took me a second to realize who it was beside me in the water. Like, I was like, who's that? Oh my God, it's John. Everybody's in the water with me right now. Like, the water was calm. It was like blue sky. Perfect day, like couldn't have asked for anything better. I felt amazing. I was in so much pain, so much pain. I was hurting, but none of that mattered. Like I knew that I was gonna get through it. I knew I would be able to like suffer through it so that I could get to the other side to be champion. The last few kilometers, I was checking my progress, and I was looking ahead much more often than I had been. I knew I was so close, and it was just a matter of minutes before I could say that I had done it. And John had said to me at one point, "Do you see the crowd? Can you hear the cheering?" And I cried as I put my head back down. I was so overcome with emotions. When I could see the break in the wall that I had to swim through to finish, I felt at that point like I had won. I felt like I had taken a trip around the universe and was landing back on Earth. At the end of the swim, I had gotten out of the water and Kyle said, "I want you to like turn around and look out over the lake." And I hadn't looked back the whole time. I was looking forward the whole time. And it dawned on me at that moment, like, I really can't see the other side. I swam that whole fucking way. How did this